students. Hello students, welcome to the next lecture of the subject of energy conservation and audit. Till last lecture we have discussed the concept of the questionnaire for energy audit projects and various equipments, instruments used in energy conservation and audit, like compact data logger, lux meters, leak detectors, speed measurements and etc. devices we have discussed. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss another concept of energy conservation and audit, that is called as energy flow diagram, or it is also called as Sankey diagram. Energy flow diagram or Sankey diagram. So this type of question was asked in winter 14, summer 16, summer 17 and summer 18, that draw energy flow diagram and state its three significance, or with an example explain how energy flow diagram helps in energy audit procedure, or what is energy flow diagram, state its significance, and or what is energy flow diagram and state its significance from energy audit point of view. So this type of four questions was asked in winter 14, summer 16, summer 17 and summer 18 respectively. So there is a chance that in summer 2021 this question may come in the examination. Either a question like draw a neat diagram for draw a neat Sankey diagram for incandescent bulb, or draw an energy flow diagram for induction motor. So this type of questions may come for 2 marks or 4 marks, 4 marks in your examination of summer 2021. So we will discuss the concept of energy flow diagram here. So first of all, we will see what is the definition of energy flow diagram. So this first point in the theme, but your definition for energy flow diagram. Energy flow diagram of any system is a diagram which shows energy distribution of system from input to output, showing the points of losses in between. This energy flow diagram or Sankey diagram can be defined as a diagram which describes, which shows you how the energy distributed to the system from input to output with the losses occurring in between them. एनर्जी फ्लो डायग्राम कशाला म्हणायचं, अशी डायग्राम ज्याच्यामध्ये आपण इनपुट टू आउटपुट मध्ये एनर्जी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कशी झालेली आहे आणि कोण कोणत्या पॉइंट्सला किती किती लॉसेस झालेले आहेत हे ज्या डायग्राम मध्ये डिस्क्राइब करतो आपण, दॅट इज कॉल्ड एनर्जी फ्लो डायग्राम और Sankey डायग्राम. सो यू शुड राईट डाऊन दिस डेफिनेशन. इफ अ क्वेश्चन अराइजेस व्हाट इज एनर्जी फ्लो डायग्राम, you have to write down this statement in that examination, that a diagram which shows energy distribution of a system from input to output, showing the points of losses in between. Okay, but why this energy flow diagram is called as Sankey diagram? This energy flow diagram is called as Sankey diagram because it was invented or named after the Irish scientist Matthew Henry Phineas Riel Sankey. This is a name of just a single person. Eka mansacha naav ahe he Matthew Henry Phineas Riel Sankey. This Irish person defined or invented this energy flow diagram to show the energy efficiency of a steam engine in 1898 for publication in a book or a newspaper for first time. To define the energy efficiency of a steam engine, now to define the energy efficiency, to describe the energy efficiency of a steam engine, it was not possible to write down the energy calculations for each and every block of the steam engine. Hence he introduced this energy flow diagram and hence this energy flow diagram is also called as Sankey diagram, and it was named after the Irish person Matthew Henry Phineas Riel Sankey. Okay, so with the help of this Sankey diagram, we can understand the internal distribution of energy to final consumption per energy system within the circuit. दिलेल्या सर्किट मध्ये इंटरनल एनर्जी डिस्ट्रीब्युशन पासून ते पर एनर्जी सिस्टीमचं फायनल कन्झम्पशन पर्यंतच्या सगळ्या स्टेप्स आपण सँके डायग्राम मधून अंडरस्टँड करू शकतो. वी कॅन अंडरस्टँड द इंटरनल डिस्ट्रीब्युशन टू फायनल कन्झम्पशन युझिंग दिस सँके डायग्राम. अँड दिस सँके डायग्राम इज ड्रॉन on the basis of energy balance calculation. It is drawn on the basis of energy balance calculation. And this diagram describes, quantify the outflows, inflows of the system in proportion to the total energy inflow. Outflow means nothing but your losses. Output and losses depict karto energy gains or inflows, energy gains and inputs sudha dakavto, and useful energy in every energy system. Tya pratyek system madhe kiti energy useful hai. For example, 100 kWh electricity mi ekade kiwa 100 watt power ekade bulb la transfer ke liye, if I have supplied 100 watt power to a electric bulb, and if I am saying that 98% energy is used to generate the light and 2% is your energy loss, so in the Sankey diagram the 98% energy will come under the heading of useful energy and 2% loss will be considered as outflow energy loss for that incandescent bulb. So how to represent that Sankey diagram, we will see in the next slide that how the Sankey diagram is represented. But this Sankey diagram can be used to find out the data of energy bills. We can find out the energy consumption from data from invoices. Whatever calculations we are doing monthly, weekly, daily, and measurements in the system. So by these four methods, you can find out the energy calculation. या चार मेथडनी तुम्ही तुमचं एनर्जी कॅल्क्युलेशन कॅल्क्युलेट करू शकता. कशा कशातून? एनर्जी बिलचा डेटा. इफ यू कॅन इफ यू क्लिअरली अँड सी द युअर लाईट बिल, देर इज अ चार्ट, देर इज अ ग्राफ ऑर देर इज अ टेबल मेन्शनिंग युअर मंथली कन्झम्पशन. फॉर एप्रिल यू हॅव कन्झ्युम दिस मंथ, फॉर मे यू हॅव कन्झ्युम दिस मच, फॉर जून यू हॅव कन्झ्युम दिस मच, फॉर जुलै यू हॅव कन्झ्युम दिस मच. So a table is shown on the electricity bill. त्या light बिलावरती एक table mention केलेला असून एक graph असतो ज्याच्यामध्ये तुमचा मे मध्ये किती एनर्जी तुम्ही वापरली, जून मध्ये किती वापरली, जुलै मध्ये किती वापरली हे सांगितलेली. So from that you can calculate the energy flow diagram. Secondly, data from invoices, how much electricity bill you are paying. लाईट बिल नसेल तुमच्याकडे पण तुम्ही किती इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल भरताय, एखाद्या महिन्यात 600 रुपये येतं, एखाद्या महिन्यात 900 रुपये येतं, एखाद्या महिन्यात 500 रुपये येतं. सो फ्रॉम दिस इनव्हॉइसेस, या बिलातून आपण पैसे जे पे केले त्याच्यातून आपण ते कॅल्क्युलेट करू शकतो. कॅल्क्युलेशन्स, इफ यू युअर सेल्फ आर टेकिंग द मीटर रिडिंग मंथली फॉर युअर कॅल्क्युलेशन, दॅट इज फॉर दिस मंथ. For example, 1000 units are consumed. In second month, it is consumed 800 units. So these calculations can also describe the Sankey diagram and measurement in the system using the energy auditing instruments which we have discussed, like data logger or lux meter, flow meter, and the combustion gas combustion analyzer, and different types of measurements in the system can depict the energy flow diagram. And the visual representation of this energy flow helps us to find out the points where maximum critical energy consumption is going on, and to identify where your maximum energy loss is taking place. हे व्हिज्युअल रिप्रेझेंटेशन मुळे आपल्या लक्षात येतं की कोणत्या पार्ट मध्ये आपली जास्त इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंझ्युम होतीये आणि कोणत्या पार्ट मध्ये आपल्याला लॉसेस आहेत हे शोधता येतं. अँड दिस विल लीड अस टू डिझाईन अँड अॅक्युरेट सिस्टीम अँड टू डिसाइड अ स्ट्रॅटेजी टू शेड्यूल द एनर्जी सेव्हिंग मेजर्स. याच्यावरून आपल्या लक्षात येईल की कुठं आपली इलेक्ट्रिसिटी वाचवायची आहे, कुठं आपली इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कन्झम्पशन कमी करायचं आहे, आणि त्याच्यानुसार तुम्हाला सिस्टीम डिझाईन करता येते. अँड हेन्स एव्हरी एनर्जी मॅनेजर रिलायज डिपेंड्स ऑन दिस एनर्जी फ्लो डायग्राम टू फाइंड आउट द पाथ व्हेअर वी कॅन इम्प्रूव्ह द एनर्जी कन्झम्पशन, व्हेअर वी कॅन इम्प्रूव्ह द लॉसेस इन द सिस्टीम. सो इन सांख्य डायग्राम वी डिपिक्ट द एरो फॉर द ब्लॉक, बट दिस विड्थ ऑफ द एरो इज इन प्रपोर्शन विथ द क्वांटिटी ऑफ एनर्जी फ्लो. हाऊ वी विल डिस्कस वेन आय विल शो यू द सांख्य डायग्राम हियर. दिस सांख्य डायग्राम इज स्पेशली यूज टू व्हिज्युअली ट्रान्सफर द एनर्जी कन्झम्पशन बिटवीन प्रोसेसेस. म्हणजे कोणत्या प्रोसेसमध्ये किती एनर्जी कन्झ्युम होती हे आपल्याला व्हिज्युअली पिक्टोरिकली चित्रांनी आपल्याला ते दिसल म्हणून आपण सांख्य डायग्राम वापरतो. अँड द कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ एनर्जी ऑडिट, दिस सांख्य डायग्राम रिप्रेझेंट्स एनर्जी फ्लो इन अ सिस्टीम हूज ऑडिट इज टू बी कंडक्टेड. ज्याचं ऑडिट आपल्याला करायचं आहे त्याची सांख्य डायग्राम आपल्याला जर आली तर आपण एनर्जी ऑडिटिंग खूप इझी पद्धतीने करू शकतो. सो हिअर इज अन एक्झाम्पल ऑफ Sankhya diagram for incandescent lamp. Now see here, an arrow is shown here. 400 joule electrical energy is consumed by the lamp, out of which 325 energy is a heat energy and 75 joule is your light energy. And see the width of the arrow. Ya arrow chi jadi baga, itha bariki itha jaste. That means here more energy is consumed and here less energy is consumed. Okay. म्हणजे असं नाही की एरो कुठे जाड काढा कुठे बारीक करा, जिथं जास्त एनर्जी कन्झम्पशन आहे तिथे तुम्हाला जास्त दाखवायचं आहे. म्हणजे 80% ऑफ एनर्जी आउट ऑफ दिस 400 जूल इज वेस्टेड इन अ हीट अँड हेन्स द विड्थ ऑफ दिस एरो इज ग्रेटर दॅन द एरो विच डिपिक्ट द युजफुल एनर्जी विच इज जस्ट 20% ऑफ युअर टोटल इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी 75 जूल. ओके, सो इन दिस मॅनर वी आर रिप्रेझेंटिंग द सांख्य डायग्राम. सांख्य डायग्राम मध्ये एरोची विड्थ म्हणजे किती एनर्जी कन्झ्युम होती त्या साईडला, किती एनर्जी लॉसेस त्याच्यामध्ये होतात हे डिफेक्ट करतो. ओके, सो इन दिस मॅनर this Sankhya diagram is represented, which helps us with the major contribution that how much overall flow of electricity is done in the given equipment or instrument. And hence Sankhya diagram is a better and simple tool to illustrate and to find out the flow which is useful and which is causing waste of energy. This is your another Sankhya diagram which is depicting the water pumping system. आपले पाण्याची जी मोटर आहे ते वॉटर पंपिंग सिस्टमची संख्या डायग्राम आहे ही. सी हिअर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी वेअर अप्लाइंग इज 100%, दॅट इज रेटेड व्होल्टेज, रेटेड करंट अँड रेटेड पॉवर वेअर सप्लाइंग टू दॅट मोटर. सो आउट ऑफ दिस 100% 45% ऑफ वर्क इज डन ऑन वॉटर, 12% goes into the pipe losses. That means if your pipe is having a loose connection or some hole, then some water will flow out from that point, so extra energy is required. So a pipe loss of 12%, valve loss of 8%, pump losses is 23%, coupling losses 2%, and motor losses are 10%. See the width of this Sankhya diagram. This is 45%. Hence, the width of this arrow is greater than all the percentages. Baki saga percentage peksha techi width jast hai. Then this is your 12%, this is your 8%, and this is your 23%, this is your 2%, and this is your 10%. So see the difference between the width of an arrow. Arrow che jadi madhe farak baga. The width of the arrow represents that maximum percentage of the power is consumed for a particular application. Here in the case of water pumping system, 45% is used in moving the water from a water source. पाण्याच्या सोर्स मधून पाणी आपण दुसरीकडे नेतोय, त्याच्यासाठी जे वर्क डन लागतं ते वर्क डन हे 45% वॉटर पंपिंग सिस्टीम मध्ये. अँड ऑल अदर लॉसेस कॉन्स्टिट्यूट युअर 55%. 55% लॉसेस आर युअर अदर लॉसेस इन्क्लुडिंग पाईप लॉस, वॉल्व लॉस, पंप लॉस अँड कपलिंग लॉस अँड मोटर लॉस. यू कॅन डिपिक्ट ऑल दीस लॉसेस इन अ सेपरेट मॅनर इन दिस मॅनर, or you can directly make a Sankey diagram in this manner. This is your 45% and this is your 55% losses. या पद्धतीने सुद्धा तुम्ही Sankey diagram represent करू शकता. That means तुम्ही total losses 55% losses एकत्र असे दाखवू शकता, or आता ही जी आधीची डायग्राम आहे त्या प्रकारे तुम्ही दाखवू शकता. बट दिस डायग्राम विल क्लिअरली टेल यू दॅट इन विच पार्ट हाऊ मच पर्सेंटेज ऑफ लॉसेस आर ऑकरिंग. याच्यामध्ये तुमच्या लक्षात येईल की कशा प्रकारे याच्यात लॉसेस होत आहेत. ओके, हेन्स दिस टाईप ऑफ डायग्राम इज प्रेफर्ड व्हाईल ड्रॉइंग युअर सँके डायग्राम फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टीम. So more comprehensive example is explained in this circuit Sankey diagram of the water pumping system, and the losses in the system are shown proportional to the width of the losses, and it depicts that what types of losses are occurring and how much inefficiency is depicted by the particular water pumping system is shown through this Sankey diagram. एक तर अशा पद्धतीने Sankey diagram तुम्ही ड्रॉ करू शकता किंवा अशा पद्धतीने सुद्धा Sankey diagram ड्रॉ करू शकता. पण ही जी सेकंड मेथड आहे ही मेथड ही सगळ्यात बेस्ट आहे, कारण ह्या प्रत्येक पॉइंटला किती तुमचा एनर्जी लॉस होतो आहे हे तुम्हाला इथे लक्षात येतं, विच वी कॅनॉट फाइंड आउट इन दिस फर्स्ट डायग्राम. बिकॉज if this diagram we have used to calculate the water pumping system, then of course it will create a confusion that out of 55% how much is your motor losses, how much is your coupling losses, pump losses is how much, valve losses is how much, and pipe losses are how much. To find out that particular losses, it will be very difficult if you represented all these losses in combined percentage, and hence separate losses are mentioned in the Sankey diagram, which is a very useful. Okay, so this was your Sankey diagram. I hope you have understood the Sankey diagram here. Try to find out the Sankey diagram for a DC motor. Okay, and homework is given to you that try to draw energy flow diagram or Sankey diagram for DC motor system. For DC motor system, that is what is the input power, and then how to represent the copper losses, iron losses, and how much power is delivered to you. Try to draw the energy flow diagram, Sankey diagram, for the DC motor system. In next lecture, we will discuss that Sankey diagram. Okay. I hope you must have understood this Sankhya diagram. After Sankhya diagram, we will move toward the next point of energy audit procedure. So, till now, we have studied the questions, what questions we should design for an energy audit procedure and in which area we have to perform the energy audit, that is understand, that is calculated using Sankhya diagram. Now, actually, what are the procedure of energy auditing? What process is carried out while energy auditing? We are going to see that point. So, in energy audit procedure, an auditor observes the pattern of energy use in particular utility. For example, if I am doing an energy audit of an industry, then as an auditor, I have to check how much energy usage is done through the electricity bill. That graph, the readings which are mentioned on that electricity bill will tell me that what is the pattern of energy use in summer season, how much electricity is used in winter, how much electricity is used in rainy season, what kind of energy consumption is done by that industry. All this pattern I have to see as an auditor, and then by observing that energy pattern, I will find out that in which area we can implement energy conservation measures so that it will be economical for industry in both electricity bill as well as cost of energy conserving measure. And this energy audit not only reduces the excess energy consumption, but it also lowers the operating cost. Okay. So, there are two types of energy audits which we are performing in any utility. First one is the walkthrough audit and second one is the detailed audit. So, in next lecture, we will discuss both these type of audit, that what is walkthrough audit, how this walkthrough audit is performed, what is the advantages of walkthrough audit, disadvantages of walkthrough audit, what is detailed audit, how it is performed, what details are taken in that detailed audit. All these points we are going to cover up in the next lecture. I hope you must have understood the Sankhya diagram. If you have any question regarding the Sankhya diagram, please you can contact me on WhatsApp and ask the any question regarding the Sankhya diagram. Okay. In next lecture, we are going to discuss these points. Try to draw the Sankhya diagram in your notebook at home. There may be a question in the examination that draw neat and labeled Sankhya diagram for particular electrical system. Means I am mentioning particular electrical system. There may be a question that draw a Sankhya diagram for water pumping system. Draw a Sankhya diagram for incandescent bulb, draw a Sankhya diagram for compressor, draw a Sankhya diagram for draw a Sankhya diagram for textile industry, draw a Sankhya diagram for sugarcane industry. So all this type of questions may come in your examination. So practice the Sankhya diagram. You yourself take one system, try to draw its Sankhya diagram. And if you have any doubt that how to draw the Sankhya diagram, you can please contact me on WhatsApp that sir, how to draw a Sankhya diagram for a particular system. So I will guide you through WhatsApp. Till then, we will stop here. Thank you.